Hello students, in previous video I have explained chapter 1 meeting season page number 1 and 2 and I have explained there was a boy Yanni. He went to live with his uncle's family in France. There he helped his uncle in his inn. One day a famous customer has came. He was a world's best painter and he has given a tip, a drawing, but by mistake Yannick has thrown it into the fire. After that her cousin Amadine become angry and he shouted on Yannick, but his uncle Bruno has told Amadine to say sorry to Yannick. After that Yannick started to cry and she become very worried and sad. On that Yannick decided to make Amadine happy. He will do something at the right time that made Amadine happy. Let's start the next page. Next morning I didn't go for my walk in the hills but made my way down through the village towards the chateau. I waited till there was no one about. I climbed the gates easily enough and then ran down through the trees. They're surrounded by the vast and threatening forest on all sides. Was the old man with very little hair who had come to the inn. He was sitting alone on the steps in the sunshine and sketching. I approached as silently as I could, but somehow I must have disturbed him. He looked up, shading his eyes against the sun. "Hello, young man," he said. Now that I was this close to him, I could see he was indeed very old, but his eyes were young, bright and searching. Next morning, I did not go for a walk. I changed my way. I go towards the chateau. I waited till there was no one about. When I went there was no one. So I climb on the gates and go inside through the gate. But when I go inside, then I saw there was a lots of trees surrounded by vast threatening forest. There was a lots of trees all the sides. And there was an old man sitting who has a little hair on his head was sitting. He was the same person who came last day in the inn. He was sitting alone on steps in the sunshine and doing some sketching. I approached as silently as I could, but somehow I must disturb him. I went there silently, but I think I have disturbed him. The old man has looked at me and told, "Hello, young man." And I was standing so close to him that I could see he is a very old man, but his eyes is filled with brightness. His eyes looks very young. "Are you Monsieur Cezanne, the famous painter?" I asked. He seems a little puzzled, so I went on. "My mother says you are the greatest painter in the world." The Yannick has asked to him, "Are you the famous painter Cezanne?" After asking this to him, he become confused. He looked little confused. So after that, I start to say, "My mother has told me about the great painter, about the greatest painter in the world, Cezanne. I think you are the one." He smiled and then laughed. "I think your mother's probably right," he said. "You clearly have a wise mother, but why did she let a young lad like you come wandering here on this own? The old man started to smile and laugh and he said, "I think your mother is right. What she has told you, she told you right thing. Your mother is a very wise lady, but why she has leave you alone to move here and there? Why you are wandering here? I explained why I had come and what I wanted. He looked at me with furrowed brows and said, I remember you now from last night. Of course, I'll draw another picture for Bruno. What would he like? No, better still, what would you like? Yannick explained all the thing to the old man. And he told, yes, I remember you, Yannick. I remember you. I have seen last night you in the inn. And definitely I will draw a picture for Bruno. Then he corrected his word and told, no, I think I will draw a picture for you. What would you like that I will draw? I like sailing boats. I said, can you do boats? Then Yannick replied, I like boats. Can you draw boats for me? I'll try, he replied with a smile. The old man told, I'll try. He's the famous painter. He's the greatest painter of the world. But he told, I'll try. It didn't take him long. He drew fast, never once looking up. But as he worked, he asked me about where I had seen sailing boats, about where I lived in Paris. He said he loved Paris and sailing boats too. He did not take too much time, and he drew very fast. But when he was drawing the picture, he's asking me question from where I have came, from where, why I love Paris, where I lived in Paris, and have the Yannick. He asked the question to the Yannick. Have you seen the sailing boat, Yannick? Where you lived in Paris? And he told that he loved the Paris and he also loved the sailing boats. There he said, tearing the sheet from his sketchbook and showing me. What do you think? Four sailing boats were racing over the sea out the beyond a lighthouse, just as I had seen them in Brittany. But he had signed it Picasso. When the painting has completed, he turned the page from the sketchbook and showing me. What do you think? Four sailing boats were racing over the sea beyond the lighthouse. But I have seen that he has signed his name Picasso. He has not written his name Cezanne. Yannick was thinking that the person is Cezanne, but what he has signed his name Picasso. It means that he is not Cezanne, he is the Picasso, the world's famous painter. I thought your name was Cezanne, I said. Yannick said to him, I thought your name is Cezanne, but you have written Picasso. He smiled up at me, how I wish it was. He said sadly, then he ordered, off you go now. Then the old man has replied to him, I wish it was Cezanne. I wish that I was a Cezanne. And he said it sadly. And then he said to him, you can go now. Now, this is the explanation of page number 3 and 4. Now, this chapter is over.